just going to be doing some keyboard ASMR. We have two different keyboards with us today. This one, which uses membrane switches, and then my second keyboard has Cherry MX switches. So those will provide you with more of that aggressive clickety-clack kind of metallic sound. And this one has a little bit of a softer, nice sound. Actually kind of like more than the Cherry MX ones, okay? So if you enjoy keyboard ASMR and hopefully enjoy the style of this video and the visuals of it and everything, make sure to leave a good old like on the video. And if you are new, please subscribe to the channel. Join in on what we got going on. It really helps out a lot, okay? And always make sure, you know, if you got any ideas for me, what you want me to do, just let me know. This is an MSI Vigor GK30 keyboard, I believe. If you want to find more of the details on it, you can just look it up. They're only about $40 to $60. Nice keyboards. I definitely recommend. Keys are actually really easy to take out, so it's good for cleaning and everything with this keyboard. Something that hopefully you can all enjoy, find the appeal in. This video is not like sponsored, I'm not getting paid to say any of this, but just getting my thoughts and opinions on it. And it has several different modes. Steady breathing where it fades in and out. This little wave one where the colors go by. This reactive one where the whole keyboard lights up. This reactive one where just one key lights up. And this one where it just stays one color. And then back to rainbow. And the other keyboard that I have actually has way more customizations. But we'll talk about that one in a minute. For now, let's just type and mess with this one for a little bit longer, and we'll switch over, okay? Everything looks all right and sounds all right. Okay. to the other keyboard, the Cherry MX1, and I have a couple of things I want to say about that one, so let's go ahead and switch over into that one. Alright, welcome back. Or I guess I should say, I'm back. I have the next keyboard here. As you can see, it is the Raydim keyboard. I don't know if it's for sale anymore. I got this a long time ago. I think it's some kind of one of those weird little knockoff whatever brand things. But I found it, I remember, for literally $20. It was very cheap. So when I first bought it, I thought it was going to be like terrible, not effective, wasn't going to last long. Colors weren't going to be crazy. But I was proven quite wrong. It's actually pretty good quality. The keys are all here, and you can hear that the Cherry MX little clickety clack, which is there. And we do have all the different colors and everything, and I forgot where the instruction manual thing or is for this thing. So all I know is it has so many different modes and different colors, way more than the MSI keyboard, which is surprising to me. And that's where I'd say that this one actually like stands out as being pretty good. As you can see, it's in the rainbow wave mode. It's going super fast. I don't remember exactly everything about how to operate this thing. I know if I press on the left and arrow keys while holding down the function, the FN button down here, that'll switch the direction that it goes. But I think this is supposed to adjust brightness, and the right and left arrow keys are actually supposed to adjust the speed of it, so I don't know why it's switching the direction. I don't know, maybe I just don't remember exactly what I'm doing here, but I'm just going to quickly go through all the modes. And then we're going to get to typing on a little bit. The only drawback I'd say that this keyboard has, which I hope y'all can't hear it too bad, when you type on it, it actually has a slight, like, metallic ringing noise. I guess because this is made out of some kind of hard aluminum or something. But you can hear it whenever you... whenever you type. So I think I'm going to make this more about exploring the colors of this, and then we'll type for like maybe 2 or 3 minutes near the end of it, okay? But as you can see, it's the rainbow mode. It's going super fast, so I don't know how relaxing that is. I believe it's on max brightness right now. But if you go and press the function button, and then press delete first off, is how you just change the colors. So we have red, green, blue, yellow, then the lighter pinkish purplish, the more aqua kind of blue, and then white, and then back to rainbow. And the other keyboard only had blue, light blue, I think red, the pinkish purplish, and then maybe green, but not as many colors. And then not as many variations, so I don't remember exactly what all the modes were called, but this one, whenever you type with a specific letter, that one letter will light up a different color each time, so it's actually pretty cool, I'd say. A little bit of the rest of the keyboard lackluster, but that's why there's more modes, right? So now we have this one. I forget what all these are called. I think this one is called wavelength because it looks like a wavelength as it goes up and down and goes through. So that one's pretty cool. You can again change the color to any specific color you want. But I would like to keep everything kind of rainbow during this. that one's pretty nice. Then we have this one, which is just like a... Oh no, everything just stays lit up all at once. Nothing changes on this. I think you can, yeah, you can change the colors, and I like how it slowly, like, fades out the colors from the middle. It's nice. See if you make a little cool effect with it if you do it like that. That one's alright. This one is the breathing one, I think, yeah. So it fades in and out, in and out, in. This is going pretty slow right now. That's how I like it, is to be slow. Let's stay calm, you know. And this one's where it just switches off to each color. So from the green to the blue to the red, yellow, green, blue, and just switches in between the colors. And this one is like the same as before, except when you press a key, it lights up that entire row going across, rather than just lighting up that individual key. So even the space bar down here will light all of that up. Each row will light up. Press on it, and it'll light up with different colors every time. That's another thing that I like. Then we have this one, which I think has something to do with the rain, like raindrops falling down. It might be called rainfall, actually. This one's a pretty cool one. Has the colors imitating like rainfall falling down. I really like the color just designs they have on this keyboard. It's really nice. If only there wasn't that slight metallic ringing sound, it'd be good. But also I realized over time that the Cherry MX keys are not quite for me, not the blue switches. It's a little too loud and obnoxious. And after a long time of, you know, trying to stream, record stuff, the keyboard can just get too loud, so that's why I like the other keyboard more. That, and also just comfortability, I'd say the other keyboard wins, but this one, hands down, is just great with all the different color stuff you can do. So then this one is like the rainbow, but it just goes in an oval form, kind of like a racetrack, just going up and down and around. I think I can switch the direction, yeah, just like that. So now it's going clockwise. That's nice. And this one I really like. It's another one where whenever you press a key, it lights up. This one lights up the entire keyboard from where you press one key. And again, different colors pop up each time. And I really just like that a whole bunch. So if you're typing real fast, your keyboard will stay lit up the entire time pretty much. And it'll keep continuously changing keys. And almost like you're the one that's causing the effect. Might be called something to do with like stars, like twinkle little star, like, you know, something like that, because each of them come on and off like they're twinkling in the nighttime sky. So that one's pretty neat, and they all twinkle a different color each time, I'm pretty sure. I think so, maybe not. Oh yeah, they do. And there's this one. I actually really like this one too. If you can't tell, it looks like it's all just staying one color, but the second you press a key, it'll actually change color after you press it. So if you look at the O right here, it's red right now. I'll press it, and it becomes a white color. The P next to it is white. If I press it, it becomes dark blue. So I actually really like this one, because it'll change with you as you go along, and you'll cause it to eventually change colors. So if I wanted to make it all red, I guess you could over time, if you just wanted to keep pressing until you got the color that you wanted. That seems a little counterintuitive. But you could just, yeah, you could just change the color like that, and they fade, and they'll fade back in the same color. And there's this one, which is like the breath again, but it has a different color for each column, or each row, my bad. So it'll fade out like that. And this one, I remember specifically, is called like gamer mode or something like that, but it highlights specifically the keys for gaming. And then if you want, you can customize it. I don't remember how. And you can customize it to light up specific keys so that you know. Like, if you're playing CSGO, you can map it out so that only the keys you use for CSGO are lit up. So like the Q, R, T, if those are the three keys you use up here, you can keep those mapped out for the hardcore gamers out there. There's this one again, but it's too fast for me, so if I'm going to type on it for another 2 or 3 minutes here, I think we're going to put it into this mode. I like this one. So now we're just going to type on this like this for 2 to 3 minutes, and then we're going to be good, okay? Keyboard for a long time, and it held up pretty well. Okay, but I think that's going to do it for this video today. Let me know how y'all like this style of video. I think it Should be pretty relaxing, pretty nice. Just different. So again, make sure to like the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you are new. Let me know what kinds of videos you want to see, what kind of videos you want to see in the future, ways I can improve. If anything seemed off, let me know. But otherwise, I hope you all have a wonderful night, wonderful evening, and I'll see you all later, okay? Goodbye.